got to this point where he's one of the top 10 pitchers in North America. So to begin with, we'll just observe Darren for 5 to 10 pitches, and afterwards we'll just talk about how he pitches and what's important to becoming an effective fastball pitcher.
One more, Joe.
Moves a lot. What do you feel is the most important part of the body when pitching fastball?
Pitching fastball would be the leg, Jojo. The drive forward. The hips. You get that drive forward. You get all your power, all your motion going into one drive and one snap. Have a lot of speed, a lot of velocity.
So you wouldn't say the arm is the most important thing? Because that's what I think most people think.
It helps with the drive and the legs. You can stand there and throw the ball. Just take a step into it. But if you take a leap towards it, you get all your weight into that one drive.
Yeah. So you're a big guy, but it wouldn't necessarily take like a huge man to throw the ball really hard.
Oh, it wouldn't. I've seen a lot of good pitchers, maybe 5'7", 5'8", yeah. Good build, but really whip the ball.
Hard.
Same velocity.
You're obviously an advanced pitcher, but for beginners, say young kids 13, 14, who want to get into the sport and want to pitch, what kind of advice would you give them about to concentrate on?
Right off the bat, that's on the practice and just take a step forward instead of taking a big leap just to get to where to put the ball. That's the main thing, is where to put the ball. You can have the least young in the world get by with placing the ball in certain places in the plate.
That's the thing, obviously, you've practiced a lot. How long have you been pitching?
I've been pitching for 11 years.
And are you still developing new pitches?
Yeah, still developing. I get a couple of pitches I don't throw in a game, but I do on the sidelines or in practice. I change curveball, I change rise ball. Sometimes you mix them in a game, but it's not a good thing because if you're turning it, looking over the fence.
Yeah, definitely. Are there any types of exercises or drills that could help a player that could say you can't find anybody to play with or anything?
Well, twisting the wrist helped me out a lot. With a hockey stick, cut off hockey stick, grow maybe 2 feet, put a string on it, and twist your wrist, maybe work yourself up there, 15, 20
pounds. Strengthen your wrist, right? Yeah, because that's what most of the, well, that's where all the spin comes, right, when you release the ball?
Yeah.
As you refer to it as snap.
Snap, yeah.
Some, you think everybody can develop that?
Well, it's not hard to develop it, it's how you get your motion going. Mm-hmm. It takes a lot of practice to do it. I don't know if too many people have the natural talent, but you gotta practice.
The next part of the video, we'll be looking at Darren through different angles. First of all, we'll be looking from behind him, like from a center fielder's view, and we'll see how the ball is approaching the plate. We'll see Darren throwing his rise ball and his fast, his harder stuff. Then after that, we'll take the umpire's view, and we'll see his change-ups. These are off-speed pitches where he has the exact same motion, but the ball's coming in much slower, and this is to get the batter off balance, and he won't have, even if he does make contact, it won't be a very effective hit at all.
By the way, Jojo, pitch that.
What's going on?
Okay. I've got the ball in there.
Is he definitely going to snap for you?
I'm recording right now.
He's recording now.
That's it?
Yep.
I'm not.
this is
right here.
Right behind here?
Yeah. I want to get the full effect of.
No.
Okay, ready? About three change-ups, three or four change-ups.
Yeah, me too.
See, fastball pitching can get to a very high level, as Darren's demonstrating. Throw a ball very hard and very soft with the same type of motion. And just as Darren emphasized before, it does take a lot of practice.
It takes a hell of a lot of practice, Jojo. A lot of summers I spent outside my head, myself, practicing.
But it does pay off. You just tell
where you've been around the world. Yes, I've been down to New Zealand, Mexico, and I've been over to, all over Canada. Mostly United States. The only place I've been was Florida.
Good. Well, I'd like to thank you a lot for coming out.
Thanks for having me.
Helping the children of North America. And I'd like to thank my catcher, Steve Nolan, and my phys ed teacher from high school, Mr. Ferguson, for taping the film. And I hope I get a really good mark on this, Sandy. Thanks a lot.